Gotta turn my phone off. You know, I think we had 131 snaps today, which was good. We got a few more than we had last week, changed some situations up. You know, we had some guys that had been banged up, which you have this time of camp, and some guys kind of pushed through. We held a few guys just for precautionary and playing as many quarterbacks as we played today was probably not fair to the offense. It's hard for a quarterback that goes out there and plays eight snaps to get in a good rhythm. You know, maybe when it's not like changing up series in a game. You play, other team has the ball, then you're back out there. But we played all, gave all four quarterbacks an opportunity today because we feel like they deserve it. And so it probably, you know, probably hindered the offense's timing and stuff there. But had some guys that I thought competed much better today on both sides of the ball. The one thing that sticks out to me when you watch us is, you know, we can get eight or nine guys to do it right on every single play. The problem is we have one or two that don't do it right. And if you don't have everybody doing it right, sometimes you ain't going to have success. So, and it's different guys every time. So, again, it's talking about being consistent, being a master at your position. We got guys that are close, and they're working hard to get there. And we've come a long ways in a short period of time. But, you know, we still got 2 weeks left before the first game, and we'll continue to grind like fall camp for probably four or five more days before we start working on West Virginia. So the next week is going to be important for our guys. It's going to be, you kind of get an idea now about who some of the guys are going to be. So you get guys slotted in on special teams, you know, and moving forward, guys will get a lot more reps at certain positions, which will help us and will improve drastically over the next weeks just from taking more reps. Without any questions.
If or when J.J. Peterson's going to join the team?
Yeah, you know, he's finishing up a class, and when he gets the class finished up, he'll be here. So would we have liked it to be in last week? Absolutely, but, you know, that's part of it. You got to do it, and he's working hard to do that.
Brian, Coach, with your offensive front, I know you said you would limit some of the
Well, I don't see it being managed any differently than it is now. You know, obviously that'd be another guy who has had absolutely no reps since we've been here. So, and he's only a sophomore, so he's not played a lot of ball. It's not like we're talking about a 3-year veteran, you know. So he'll have a lot to learn, and I'm sure his learning curve, you know, he's going to have to learn on the go. And we've moved guys around all camp because you never know. I mean, you could lose guys at any point in time just trying to create depth. And I think Coach Friend and Coach Helton have done a good job with all the players on offense moving guys around to try to create depth, which is important for us.
Jeremy, you mentioned you guys held some guys out. Who were some of those guys, and specifically did Chance and Juwan and Darren scrimmage today?
Well, we did not scrimmage Darren today. Just again, he wanted to, he felt great, but just going back to what we decided to do back before camp started, we were going to work him a certain amount of days and then give him a certain amount of days off just for recovery to build him back. This is the same way with Juwan. You know, you got guys that hadn't performed at a high level in a very long time. If you go out there and just throw them in the fire, you know, their body can't adapt. It's going to shut down. So we're just trying to build it up, build up their endurance, and that will be with all of them. So, but, yeah, he was one guy that we held out.
Jeremy, after two scrimmages now, where do you see your quarterback situation at? Has anybody separated themselves at this point?
You know, every day when you watch practice, all four guys do some really good things. Again, it's about being consistent, and it's about making the critical errors You know, I mean, if you look at a drive, you march down through there 7 to 10 plays, but it only takes one play to mess up the drive, you know. So we've got to stay out of the negative plays. And our guys have been, you know, reducing those every day. You know, obviously JT, you know, being the youngest guy, not being here and being new to college, he is, you know, he probably hit a wall to start camp, but now things have kind of slowed down for him. The guy has some arm talent, so we wanted to give him some opportunities today.
Jeremy, a couple questions. First off, with the corners, are things starting to take shape a little bit there? Or are you getting a better feel for that? And secondly, with the freshman defensive linemen, are any of those guys looking like guys who can step up and help and not just because you need them to?
Right. Well, most freshmen, no matter where they go to school, you can sit there and meet with them all summer, or you can meet with them in fall camp. And when you start talking about pace of practice, the competition on the field, it gets overwhelming everywhere, you know. So that's why you see very few freshmen that come out and start the first game. You know, our guys are developing, all of them, the guys on offense, on defense, Paxton Brooks at punter, they're all developing, improving every day. So I think the more knowledge they get about what they're supposed to do, and they get to watch guys do it kind of the right way, it gives them an idea. So we're happy that the direction all these guys are headed.
Jeremy, how long can you go into camp giving the four quarterbacks a shot before you have to focus on somebody for the continuity of the offense?
You know, there's a fine line there, but I think that because of the reps that we take on two spotting, the guys get a lot of opportunities. We've been doing this all camp. So, you know, I think eventually when the first guy or the second guy or the third guy kind of shows himself, then we'll whittle it down. But until then, we'll just kind of stay status quo till we figure it out.
Jeremy, what kind of mentality have you seen out of Jameer Johnson, and what do you like him at right now?
You know, Jameer is a really good competitor. He's got good balance, body control, plays with power. He's not an overly big guy, but he's got some power in his body. He can play probably all five spots on the offensive line. Again, this is new for him. He's coming from junior college, didn't play, but I think 1 year in high school, maybe 2 years. So, you know, he's learning the way we want to practice. So, and he didn't get here until summertime. So, he's really improved the last probably 5 or 6 days. So we think he's got a bright future.
Coach, you said after Sunday, edge pressure was a problem. Did that get cleaned up today? And you know, was that a positive on the defense, or more of a breakdown on the offense when that's happening?
You know, when you talk about protecting the quarterbacks, there's a bunch of variables that are involved, whether it's, you know, the O-line being on the same page. Hey, it may be the quarterback. He may supposed to know that, hey, if this guy comes, I'm supposed to get rid of the ball. You know, it might be a running back. So, again, it kind of goes back to when you got a bunch of new guys that are playing together for the first time, and they're not, you know, every day they're kind of swapping groups, and not just at quarterback. It's offensive linemen. It's tight ends. It's running backs. Because we're trying to figure out who the best guys are, and then as we move forward here in the next 3 or 4 days, we'll figure it out, and we got to have a starting point, and that will be it. And then we'll give guys opportunity as we go through the season. But, you know, at some point in time, we've got to pick a lane a little bit at all positions.
Jeremy in the back. Did Juwan scrimmage today? And secondly, after the first scrimmage, you kind of lamented maybe some issues in the tackling department. How did that go with the added snaps today and just the overall scrimmage?
Yeah, Juwan did scrimmage. You know, unless we make every tackle, I'm never going to be happy with how we tackle. And sometimes getting them on the ground, you might not be tackling the right way, you know, playing with the right technique. So we have a long ways to go to be able to tackle the way that we want to be able to when it comes to fundamentals and technique. Our guys are working hard to improve on it. And I can see them getting better at it, and I see confidence in them. but we still got a long ways to go.
Jeremy, can you touch on some things that you liked about what you saw from today's scrimmage?
You know, to start the scrimmage, I really felt like the offensive line kind of dominated the scrimmage with the ones and the twos, even the threes. I thought they'd done a good job. You could see the line of scrimmage changing, which that don't say much about the defensive front. But as practice went, you know, I felt like that whether it's the plays, whether it's the you know, how hot it was or how many snaps, you know, guys have taken. You saw guys that wasn't performing at the end of the practice like they were at the beginning, you know. So that's not exactly what we're looking for. We'd like to finish better than we start. So we've got to improve there. And when you watch tape, have a lot better idea. But I just know standing out on the field, you know, you see the line of scrimmage move. So it's good and bad.
Jeremy, can you break down sort of what defensive play calling is going to look like on game day? How much of that are you going to shoulder, and what is that process going to look like?
Well, you know, with Kevin, Charles, Tracy, Chris, all of those guys I've worked with before. So really any of those guys could call our defense. All of them could. But as we go through the season – you know, we'll put the game plan together as a group. You know, I'm not leaving Terry out. Terry just hadn't been with us before, you know, so he's learning the stuff and he is doing a really good job at it. But when we get through the season, you know, I'll probably call the defense.
Wes?
Jeremy, in light of some of that stuff that's happened up there at Maryland, how tough is it as a coach to kind of push your guys but make sure you're not pushing them too hard? And how much has that process with all the science stuff and sports science, how much has that changed from when you were a player to now?
You know, I don't know much that's happened there, so I'm probably not the right person to ask about that. I know from my standpoint, you know, is it different now than it was when I played? Absolutely. You know, and maybe that's because we're smarter. You know, as coaches and technology, and you learn things. I mean, heck, right now, I mean, I had a guy call me the other day, and he said, I got to ask you a question. He said, you're telling me that they can wear a vest and you know how fast they're running? I said, yes, sir, and how many yards they've ran and how many 12-mile-per-hour bursts or 15-mile-per-hour bursts. So from technology standpoint, obviously it helps you with soft tissue injuries. It gives you an idea. You know, you look out here and you got one wide receiver that runs 9,000 yards in a practice and a guy that plays the same position only runs 5. Something's not right there, you know. So for us, we use our GPS system to get an idea of that, to make sure that everybody's taking the same amount of reps and nobody's kind of out of whack there.
Final question, Ryan.
Coach, you touched on it a second ago with the defensive line, but what kind of camp have those guys had so far, just overall, and have you come along, I guess, in developing some depth with some of those young guys you have behind the veterans there?
Well, you know, I would say the defensive line is probably like every position we on our team. You know, every position we've got has had some really good days, okay? But we've not done it every single day, you know, and for us to be the kind of football team that we want to be, we've got to develop the right habits. To kind of play to a standard every single day, creating the right habits, you know. So everybody on our football team has flashed at some point or another during this fall camp, you know. But there is some guys that are, you know, probably doing it a little more consistently than others. There's a lot of guys that I've seen lots of improvement over the last 2 weeks. So we're headed in the right direction. We got to bring some more guys with us. We've got some guys that have the ability, but right now they don't have the knowledge because they're inexperienced, and they'll improve over the next, you know, 3 to 4 weeks. And hey, there may be some guys that don't play much early in the year, right, but by the fifth or sixth game they might be guys that might be starting for us and playing, you know, meaningful time. So that's why we practice the way we practice, so we can help develop all of our players in our program, you know. And I think it'll pay off for us in the long run.